The Formula One circus has made its way to the southern coast of Portugal this week, and it's preparing for what I expect to be a terrific race here in Portimão. ...2.9 miles of track at Portimão, featuring 15 turns, 9 to the right and 6 to the left. There's a lot going on here, a lot of elevation changes that will affect the driver's braking and acceleration. Keep an eye out for the DRS zone on the final straight. That will be the setup for a lot of today's overtaking chances. Anthony Davidson, a very warm welcome to you as you join me in the commentary box for today's event. Let's talk about Alpine. There have been some tweaks to the power unit regulations, of course, and I have to say it doesn't seem, so far at least, that they've been able to keep up.
It doesn't look promising for them so far. And if the new regs have hit them as hard as we think, well, I suspect they may need a few late nights at the factory to get back on track.
It's time to see how our drivers are stacking up after yesterday's exciting qualifying session. Young superstar Max Verstappen starts from pole position. Sergio Perez lines up alongside. Looking at the rest of today's grid, we have Russell, Leclerc, Carlos Sainz, and Button, Tsunoda, Bottas, Norris, and Lance Stroll, Ricciardo, Ocon, Robert Schwartzman, and Giovinazzi. Eilert, Tictum, Nicholas Latifi, and Mick Schumacher. Armstrong, Mazepin, Joe. They'll be starting further back after an earlier grid penalty. And the owner driver. And with lights out just moments away, it's time to go down to the track.
Now that we've got some points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another top 10 finish.
Yes, 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 we're on the podium. Good job this weekend, great drive, thank you.
Victory for the team from Milton Keynes then, after a quality performance. So, Anthony, what made the difference out there today?
Well, time management probably played quite a large role in the outcome of this one. As ever, it's not just about speed, it's all about maintaining that speed consistently over a stint, over a race distance. So being able to keep up the lap times while still being smooth on the controls and gentle on the tyres, that's really where the race was won today.
Red Bull put up an outstanding fight for the front position today, and it's great to see it paid off for them. They do so much for the sport that you can't help but be delighted by today's race win. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. And the championship leaders secured more points today, pushing their lead out even further at the top of the standings. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I'm going to give it to the owner driver today. There was a lot going on all down the field, but they were the only one who I really felt maximised their potential.
It's time to check out the constructors' standings. No change in the top spot, but with today's points, their hold on the lead is getting weaker. Meanwhile, Alpine move up the table with another strong performance this weekend. I'm equal parts exhausted and elated with this weekend of Formula One. Be sure to join us for the next one.
The fans really seem to enjoy that. You made it look easy. You're breaking all expectations. What's your secret? It was more like Dodgems than Formula One today, wasn't it? Great. Well, that's everything.